हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू youtube.com/Dr. वेट चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर इन हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। इन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डील विथ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बैक्टीरियल डिजीज, टिटेनस। इन टिटेनस पार्ट वन वी विल डिस्कस सिनोनिम, इंट्रोडक्शन, इटियोलॉजी एंड एपिडेमियोलॉजी। फ्रेंड्स, इंपॉर्टेंट सिनोनिम ऑफ द टिटेनस इज लॉक जॉ। लॉक मीन्स लॉक्ड, जॉ मीन्स जॉ ऑफ द माउथ। इन दिस सिनोनिम द थिंग्स आर दैट mouth is head tightly closed, mouth is tightly closed. Separation of jaw is very very difficult due to spasms of the masseter muscles of the jaw. So the name is given lock jaw. We discuss here introduction of tetanus. Tetanus is an infectious disease of all mammals, and it is affected by or caused by specific neurotoxin produced by organism Clostridium tetani in necrotic tissue. Though this is an infectious disease, it is a non-contagious disease. There is no temperature in this disease, non-febrile. All mammals are susceptible. Disease is characterized by spasmodic contraction of skeletal muscles of the whole body. That is the characteristic of this disease. Friends, here we discuss etiology of tetanus. Tetanus is caused by Clostridium tetani organism. Organisms are gram positive. They are long slender rods. They are anaerobes with rounded ends of the rod. The characteristic of this organism is they develop a spore and a terminal spherical spore and a long slender rod shaped body, giving a typical appearance of a drumstick. So typical drumstick appearance of the spore of this Clostridium tetani is the characteristic. Friends, we continue etiology. These organisms, Clostridium tetani, found in the soil, and they are normal inhabitant of intestine of herbivore. So infection is everywhere. Clostridium tetani grows mainly under strict anaerobic condition. This is important condition. The Clostridium tetani occur in two forms, spore forms and vegetative forms. The spore forms are very much resistant, and spore persistent in soil for many years. Spores are resistant to many disinfectants and eat. The vegetative forms are destroyed by heat and disinfectants. Continue with the etiology. Friends, remember, spores require anaerobic condition for germination in the womb. So for to convert it to vegetative form, spores require anaerobic condition. So local tissue necrosis is a favorable condition for germination of the spore. It is important thing that spores persist as a dormant form in tissues for many months, and even in Hindwood also. Whenever there is opportunity, the spore convert into the vegetative form and produce the disease. The spores in favorable anaerobic condition develop germination, vegetative form, and produce disease. Continue with the etiology. On conversion of the vegetative form, the Titanae organism produce three types of toxins under anaerobic condition in the necrosed wound. The three types of toxins are tetanospasm, it is a neurotoxin, tetanolysin, it is a hemolysin, fibrinolysin, it is a muscle and tissue cell lysis. Of these three toxins, important toxin for the production of disease is neurotoxin tetanospasm. Remember, tetanospasm or neurotoxin is important for development of the tetanus. Here we discuss some of the epidemiological factors. Prevalence of infection. Disease is worldwide distribution, present in all countries. But the incidence of tetanus is more in tropical countries than in temperate zones. The incidence is higher in warmer zones of the various countries. The warmer parts are more favorable for the tetanus. Continue with the prevalence of tetanus. Tetanus is sporadic disease in India. The case fatality rate is very high, maybe over 80% in young cattle. The mortality rate may be 50% in animals, and the death is due to acute infection. It causes contraction, spasmodic contraction of all muscles of the body. So respiration and other parts of the body are also affected. Here we discuss predisposing factors. The Clostridium tetani organism present in soil. But under the influence of climatic condition and environmental influences, it causes infection of the skin wound or injury. Skin wound or injury is a must for entry of spore into the body. There are many injuries caused to the skin during shearing, docking, parturition, and many injuries. We will discuss later on the detail of this type of injuries. Sources of infection of Clostridium tetani. Infected soil contain Clostridium tetani. We know that the Clostridium tetani are the normal inhabitant of the intestine flora of the ruminants. So infected feces is the potential source of the infection. Feces is an important source. Other sources are infected discharges and environment. But feces and soil are the two main important sources of infection. Friends, we discuss here transmission of Clostridium tetani organism. We know that the organisms survive for a very long period in soil and feces in a spore form. The spores are very resistant. The spores enter mainly through deep puncture wound. Deep puncture wound is a must for the development of the disease that produce anaerobic condition. The neonates get infection through umbilicus at the time of birth. The spread can also occur through ingestion of the organism, but main route is deep puncture wound. Friends, we know that the spore of Clostridium tetani enter through deep wound or injury. There are many ways to create a wound. Wound occur due to parturition, at the time of parturition, during prolapse, during castration operation, during shearing operation, during vaccination program we are giving injection, during injury due to grazing, unprotected surgery, if surgery is not protected completely, may get the infection. Infection get during retention of placenta, during docking operation, injection given during treatment, spaying surgery, injury during transport, injury during plowing, accidental injury. There are many ways the animal get the injury and entry of spore through the wound. Which are the host susceptible to the tetanus? Friends, remember, all mammals are susceptible. Among these, horses and mules are highly susceptible of all species. So it is a disease of horses and mules. Cattle is relatively less susceptible than men and horses. The ruminants are comparatively less susceptible. The reason is there is growth of Clostridium tetani organism in the rumen, and that causes production of natural antitoxin in the serum of ruminants, and which give resistance to the ruminants. So cattle are relatively less susceptible. Continue with the susceptible host. Sheep, goat and pigs are more susceptible as compared to cattle. The dogs are relatively resistant. Cat is even much more resistant. Birds are quite resistant. So tetanus do not occur into the birds. The horses and mules are the highest susceptible, less susceptible cattle, sheep and goat pigs are comparatively more susceptible than cattle, dogs and cat are relatively resistant, and birds are quite resistant. Friends, here we have discussed very important disease, tetanus. From all angles, it is very much important. From field angle, education angle, important. We discussed here synonym, introduction, etiology, and epidemiology. Requested to share this information to veterinary friends and veterinary students to promote the channel, subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing this video.